Hello guys, my name is Hardevinder. Today we are going to solve this IGCSC paper 3, data analysis and web authoring. This is the third paper of October-November 2019. Today we will cover this data analysis part and web authoring we will discuss in the later on. So let us start with the paper. Very first task is evidence document. Open this document and enter your name, center number and candidate number, so they will appear on every page of this document. Save this as Word process document. If your work area is the file is evidence, you followed by your candidate number, for example like this. You will need to place answers to questions and screenshots in the evidence document. So very first thing, we'll have to open this evidence document and 19 evidence. So we have the source files here. There is source files, and this is the evidence document. Open it in a word processor for 2 seconds. We have to write your name, center number and candidate number in the header section or footer section. They have asked that this information should be displayed on every page of the evidence document. That means you need to place it in the header or the footer section. So we will place it in the header section. Go in insert and then header and footer, header. Here you can write your candidate number. Suppose your name is Hardevinder Singh and center number is N01 and 001, and candidate number is 4 times 1. Then save this file followed by your candidate number in word process format. Go in file, save as. I have a work area folder here, and then you have to save it followed by your candidate number. So candidate number is 4 times 1 1 2 3 4. So this file has been saved in the ODF format. Save it. So next, they are asking you will need to place the answers to questions and screenshots in evidence document. Now task 2, spreadsheet. You are going to prepare invoice using a spreadsheet for Super Disk Sales. This company makes and sells storage devices. All prices are in euro, which must be displayed in 2 decimal format places. Open and examine these files, invoice, CSV and SST, CSV in the spreadsheet package. So we'll have to examine these 2 files, invoice CSV and SST CSV, in our source file. Here is, we are having invoice CSV. Open it, and then we are having SST.CSV. Save these both files in your work area in the spreadsheet format. Here is, we are having work area. So here you can save this file in ODF format. Save it, and this also file save as in spreadsheet format in desktop in work area. So these both files we have saved. Now using a file invoice.csv, merge cells A1 to G1, merge cells A9 to G1, format both the merged cells to have white center line, 36 point sans serif font on black background. Format the top of the spreadsheet look like this. So you'll have to format your web procedure for the invoice here. A1 to, they have asked A1 to G1. A1 to G1 merge and center, increase the size up to 36, background color they want black and foreground automatically white, then background black 36, then merge and apply this. All format borders, and here also will have to apply the all borders. So let us move further. This product code, etc., we need to make them bold. These mold and increase little bit large them, and increase the size because this is not visible. So okay, now further At the bottom of the spreadsheet format, only the cells which contains test to be bold and look like this. So this at the bottom we have already formatted this one. So leave these. Only these which are having the test will have to format. So no formatting is need to apply the rest of the cells and make them in bold. Shortcut for bold is Control B, and then save the spreadsheet with the file name invoice followed by the your number, center number, candidate number and invoice number. So save your file again. We have already saved. We'll have to rename it. File, and then save as, and give the name. Here we need to place a center number, that is suppose N double 01, and here 4 times 1 2 3 4. Save your file in work area. Let us try again. Here N01 and 4 times 1 1 2 3 4. Save your file. Let's move further. Place the test invoice date followed by automated date left line in the header section. In the header section we'll have to place this 9 mask task we have already completed. So very good. Now invoice date will have to place in the left line in the header section. So go in insert and pick this header and footer, and the hidden header section left line will have to place invoice date and automated date. Automated date you can pick from here. So here automatically the date will be coming here. And place the name and center number and candidate number right aligned in the footer. And this again insert and go in in insert and header and footer. In the footer section will have to place in the right side. I think they have asked in right line. Yes, name, candidate number and candidate center number and candidate number, these things will have to place in the footer section right line. So name, here you need to write the name. Center number, suppose that is a N 3 times 01, and then candidate number, that is suppose 1111. So okay, so this task we have completed, 2 marks task. Next, place a function in C12 to F12 to look up the make, model, capacity and unit price of these items using a product code for the lookup values and external file SST.csv for array. So here, what is the target? In C12 to F12 we'll have to write the formula to look up the make, model and capacity and unit price of that particular product according to that product code which we will enter. So here is the product code. Whatever the product code we will enter, we need here make, model, capacity and unit price automatically. So where from where we need to pick this make, model, capacity and unit price, that we will pick from this file SST. If I'll enter SST code, this SST4, then the make will be Samsung and model will be 850 EVO and capacity will be 120 and unit price will be 82. So accordingly we'll have to make the formula. So the names, models and capacity of the product will be from SST file we'll have to pick. So we will have to make the formula here. Very first, make formula. So for make we'll have to write a VLOOKUP, and from here we'll pick the lookup value. Here we'll write the product code, then comma, then we need the array from where we need to pick the model make. So copy this array. Students, in array make is in the 1 2 3 4th, fourth column. The make is in fourth column, so comma put here 4. 4 means the fourth column will have to pick the make, and then comma 0 for exact match and 1 will be for approximate match. So here's showing nothing NA because we have not entered any product code. So suppose I enter here this product code, this SSD 11, suppose here I'll enter SSD 11. So crucially you can see SAD 11 is this for make it showing. So similarly we'll have to write the VLOOKUP formula for model also. VLOOKUP and then lookup value is suppose this, and then comma table array. Table arrays again you can copy this one, and now we are finding the model. Model is in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 fifth column, so we'll have to write here 5 and then write 0 and enter. So this is the model. Similarly we'll have to make the capacity B lookup, then lookup value is here and the comma, then we need to pick the array. And here we need capacity. Capacity is in this 1, 2, 3, third column. So here we'll write 3 and then 0 for exact match. Capacity, then unit price we need. Similarly, we look up and again we'll have to pick this array. And unit price in second column, comma 2 and comma 0. So this we have done. There is an array, we forgot to write the lookup value. Here is a lookup value, comma. So I think VLOOKUP is clear to everybody. There are 4 parameters in lookup value. Very first thing is a lookup value, from where we will pick the lookup value. Then array we will select the array from where we need to pick the values, like make, model, capacity. And then from the selected which column we want to pick the index, column index of that first column, second column and third column. Then 0 or 1. 0 means exact match and 1 means approximate match, and then that's why we are using 0 for exact match. If your data is not in ascending or descending order, you can use exact match, means you can apply 0 here. So this task we have done. Now next they are asking for, make sure that if no data is entered in the product code column, that nothing is displayed in these cells. Make sure that if no data is entered in the product code column, then nothing is displayed in each these cells. Students, if we are not entering any product code, it's showing error. But they are saying if we are not entering anything, nothing should be displayed here. So we need to apply the if function here. If the value here in product code is blank, then here and here the value should be blank, not an error. NA, hash NA value should not be displayed. So very first thing you should know the if function. I'll teach you the if function. If function is like this. If suppose I show you, if the student is getting more than 35 marks, he will be declared as a pass, otherwise he will be declared as a fail. So I'll give you an example. 35 I write here. If the students are getting the whatever marks we will write in this L18 is greater than or equal to 35, then he will be declared as pass, otherwise he will be declared as fail. So if I write here 35, it will show pass. If I write here 34, it will be fail. If I write here 46, it will show pass. So in if document, if function, the first is a condition. If the condition is true, this first statement will execute, and if the condition is false, then this second statement will execute. So similarly, we'll have to apply the formula here. If this A12 is blank, then there should not be any value to display here. But if that is something is here, then the VLOOKUP formula should be applied only. So we'll have to apply the if function here. If the value in this column is equal to blank. Blank means I started the inverted comma and close, means nothing is there, then it should print blank. Otherwise it will find for the lookup values. So I have applied a formula in that further in VLOOKUP. If the value in A12 is blank, then nothing will be displayed here, otherwise VLOOKUP formula will be applied. So it's showing nothing if I am not entering anything. If I enter here anything, suppose SSD 11, I'll enter here, SSD 11. Then it will display the values, otherwise here it's showing blank because we have applied. Here again we'll have to apply the same. If value in this cell is equal to blank, then nothing should be displayed, otherwise this VLOOKUP formula will be applied. And okay, similarly here, if value in this A12 is equal to blank, then nothing to be displayed, otherwise value. Similarly here, if equal to blank, so this is done. So move further. Replicate these function in functions for row 13 to 23. Yes, students, from 13 to 23 will have to replicate this formula. But when I am replicating this formula, what you are watching here this formula, what happening here, the range is A22E06 E106 E2 A22. But when I'm replicating up here, it is showing A32E107. Here is showing A42108. But we want that array should remain constant, means it should not change this array, because the values from where we are picking, these are here from A22E106 up to here E106. We want these array reference should remain same, but this lookup value will change, because whatever the lookup value will enter here, according to that make will be displayed here, whatever will write here according to that. Where here we need this lookup value, we want to change, but the array we want that should remain same. So we need to make it a constant. For making it a constant, we can apply the absolute reference. We can put a dollar sign before the both the coordinates, and the shortcut for applying a absolute reference, we can press F4, and here also we can press F4 and then enter. F4 and then drag down up to 23. So now you can check this reference is constant, but this is a lookup value changing, but the reference is common in each whenever we are driving. Similarly, same problem is here. Firstly, we'll have to copy the formula to E23. Same problem is here. So again, we have to make it constant by applying absolute reference and enter. So again, and again here also F4 and F4. Here also. So this we have done. Now move further. This 15 marks task we have covered. Keep in mind this formula is having heavy weightage, 15 marks. So very good, we have done this. Now place in a cell G12 formula to multiply the number of items by unit price, and make sure that if no data is entered in the number of items column, then nothing should be displayed. Nothing is displayed in the cell. Replicate the formula for row 13 to 23. So in G12 we'll have to find the formula for calculating unit price by the number of items. I'll write unit price is number of items are here, and multiply by unit price is here in E12. So enter. They are saying if nothing value is there, if I'm not entering anything here, then unit price should not show anything, any error. Here we were having a formula, by mistake we have removed that. if I write here as SSD 11, it shows items 10. But if we are not entering anything, it should not display any error. So again, we'll have to write it in a if function. If the value here in btwalloc is equal to blank, then it will print blank. Otherwise, it will multiply. So similarly, btwalloc should otherwise btwalloc by f12 multiply. Multiply means f12. Yeah, something went wrong. So in if we are not entering anything, it should display blank. So this is okay. Now again we need to replicate the formula. Now we won't apply any absolute reference because we need to change. And next time we'll have to multiply this by this this unit price, and here B16 by F16. So we will not apply absolute reference here for calculating the prices. So this is done. Make sure that no data is entered. The replicated we done. This 2 marks task we have already done. Now place in B24 function to calculate the total number of items ordered in B24. In B24, here is B24, we'll have to calculate the total number of items. So here we can use the sum function, sum, and select the range for which we want to do the sum, and then press enter here. And next, in G4 function to calculate total price column, total price, here we need to calculate the total price, G24. So here you again you can apply sum and give the range which sum you need and apply here. So this 2 marks and this 1 mark target we have done. Place in G cell in E25 nested if function to display the discount rate percentage referring to the date in column I and J depending upon the total number of items ordered. Note that the discount rate is in cell J6 is used if total number of items ordered does not meet with the criteria in cell I32, I15. This 4 marks question. So in E25, we'll have to write E25 here. Discount. Discount will have to calculate accordingly. If the number of items ordered here, these number of items are ordered less than 10, then no discount rate. If that are less than 20, then 0.5 means half percent, and if less than 50, then 0.1 means 1%, and if the items are more than 50, then 2% discount rate is there. So we'll have to apply the formula in E25 here. So here we can write if the value here is greater than is less than this, then discount rate will be this. But if again we'll have to write if the value in this is less than this 20, then discount rate will be this. Again, if B24 value is less than this I, and discount rate will be this, else discount rate will be this. So this is a formula. If the value in B24 is less than I3 means less than 10, then discount rate is nothing, means J3 means 0. If value in B24 is less than I4 means less than 20, then discount rate is J4 means 0.05%. if value in B24 is less than 50 means I5, then discount rate is 1, and otherwise all that discount rate will be 0.2. so apply this formula here accordingly. Now this 4 marks question we have done. Now place in cell G24 the formula to calculate the discount amount, which is discount rate multiplied by the price before discount. So discount will have to calculate here. Discount price before discount multiplied by discount rate. We have applied this formula. this task we have completed 8th. Now we are on the 9th. Place in G26 the formula to calculate a total which is price before discount. This we have done minus the discount. Place in G26 formula to calculate the total is the price before discount minus discount. So here we will have to calculate the price. Price before discount minus discount. So here discount total will be calculated. Apply appropriate formatting in the cells containing numeric values rows 12 to 26. 12 to 26 will have to apply appropriate formatting. Already this is already applied. One mark task we have already applied the border here. So don't need to do again. Save your spreadsheet. Print the entire spreadsheet showing the values. Please note that you have not yet have any entered by data into the invoice. Make sure printout it fits to a single page, contains all the cells for fully visible and with no split words. Grid lines are displayed, row, column and headings are displayed. This two mask task will have to show. Keep in mind, will have to show rows and column headings while taking the printout. Means these rows numbers 1, 2, 3, 4 and these column headings should be displayed on the printout. Let us check the print preview. When we are checking the print view, what is we are seeing, this row numbers and column headings are not showing, but it's on a fit on a single page, it's okay, but it's not showing on the single page, it's showing on double page. So we can apply this landscape. Let us check for the landscape. Go in format, then page, and landscape. So let us check file. Print preview. Now it's on a single page, but row headings and column headings are not there. So we'll have to show view, and here we can apply. You can go format, then page, then sheet, column and row headers. You can apply here columns and row headers. Now see the print preview. Now it's showing row headings and column headings. So we are not going to take the printout, we can save it. You can see this, your name, center number and candidate number is displayed, and your invoice date and your grant date is also displaying here. So save it as a PDF. Later on we will take the printout. Export in our work area. I have saved this file. So now go in the normal view. Next, and this task we have completed. Print your spreadsheet showing the formulas. Earlier we have shown the only values, but now we need to print to show the formulas. It is landscape orientation, row headings and column headings are displayed. It's the content of all cells are fully visible. So we'll have to show the formulas, whatever the formulas we have applied. So we can go in the view and then show formula option is here. Formulas are, all formulas are showing, but not visible all. So we can see in print preview. Go in format, then page, in sheet, formulas. Now check. Showing all formulas, but these are not fully visible. So for making them fully visible, we'll have to increase the sizes. So now file, print preview. Still the formulas are not fully visible. We'll have to show them in a full visible strength. Then go format, page, sheet. It should be a single page wide. So apply here fit to fit print range width height to a single page width and single page height. Okay, now see the print preview. It's showing on a single page, everything is displayed, but unnecessarily these columns are bigger, so we can reduce their size. So here we can reduce their sizes. These are not required to so big. And similarly these because there is not any formula in this. So go in prevent preview and check. So now it's okay. All formulas are visible and showing values. So now we can save it as a PDF. Go export as PDF. Export and you have work PDF. Yes. Now move further. This one mark task. Before the invoice will be used, it needs to be tested. Test one will use normal data, including this task we will discuss in the later on. So this is enough for today. This task we can complete. Examine the formula in G12 and use the complete the table identifying the cell reference where SSD1 will be entered, another appropriate test data. So this we can do in the later on. This 5-mark task we will cover in the next video. For this video, sign off. Thank you. Thanks for watching.